Hello friends, in this video I want to update on the new version of VALTRACK series GPS tracker we designed. And this device is meant for vehicle tracking applications, and the new version is called VALTRACK-V2C. This device is the successor of VALTRACK-V2 and the V2B. For those who don't know or who have not followed my previous videos, V2 is a personal tracking device. It's a 2G GSM GPS tracking device, and it can run from 5V to 12V power inputs, and it can run from lithium batteries. On the other hand, V2B is a 2G GSM GPS tracker for vehicle tracking applications. It can run from 12V to 28V of input. V2B was created for applications that need to have higher input voltage capacity, and V2C is a hybrid of both. It can run from 5V to 36V input, and it also has internal lithium battery charging support for power backup applications. This was done mainly because people started asking for a device which has both the features of V2 and V2B, which are mainly higher input voltage rating and the ability to run off an internal lithium ion battery. This is to avoid the device going to shut down when the main power supply has been removed, which happens in case of vehicle thefts. Apart from the main change of the power supply design, we added support for RF transmitter here, which was requested by a client for activating garage doors. So this is the connector that has been added here. As you can see in this image shows how the RF transmitter is connected. We selected the SYN-115 transmitter module for this application. The 433 MHz RF modules are used to control the relays which are driving the garage doors motors in some places. And this addition of RF transmitter will help in controlling the doors sitting inside the car by sending an SMS or call or through the internet. The RF module can be turned off by using a MOSFET if not needed to conserve power. The RF transmitter is not available in general releases and only available on request. Another notable change is the nano SIM card connector. We have changed the SIM card from push-pull type to a push-push type. So you push the card inside and you again push it back to retrieve the card out. The inputs and outputs available on the device are as follows. There are two digital inputs and one analog input, and there are two digital outputs which are going through a MOSFET driver. So you can control two relays using these two outputs. The analog input is also connected internally to the main power input of 12 to 36 volt, and it is connected through a resistor divider. You can configure the resistor divider to read the input voltage of the main battery as well as in addition to the internal battery voltage. This is useful in monitoring the main battery voltage and determine its health and inform for service and maintenance. Coming to the other side of the board, the GSM module used is the 2G quad band module SIM800C, and the GPS module is the same SIM39EA, and it can also be replaced with a mobile tech N39 also. The same accelerometer MMA86-52 has been added in this design, and it's the same one which was used on the VALTRACK-V2 and the V2B. I don't like to change the parts in the design unless the requirements mention it, because using same parts helps in keeping the unknowns at bay and save precious development time, and that's why our software and firmware which works for V2 also runs on V2B and also on V2C. The V2B had a request recently to get it working on the Google Cloud IoT platform, and we got it working with the same design with an MCU change from STM32L0 to STM32L4. As a JWT generation needed more resources which were satisfied by L4 series, the necessary hardware additions were done to the V2C to make it easy for GCP integration. V2C form factor is slightly bigger compared to the V2B and the V2 by a small amount, say a few mm. All the inputs and outputs I just mentioned are all routed to this through-hole connector, which is a 2.54 mm header here. Also, there is support for EEPROM or FRAM, which can be used for storing logs or configuration information. To tell about the firmware features of the device, it can handle the following configuration. It can be set into SMS tracking mode with the SMS reply back on receiving SMS commands, and it can be set into long interval tracking mode with the deep sleep options or standby modes, wherein the GSM and GPS everything is turned off and it only wakes up at a certain time and enables all the modules and sends up data and again goes back into low power mode for this is useful for low usage battery conserving applications. And the next mode is the continuous non-stop mode, wherein it will keep sending the data continuously at set intervals with everything turned on all the time. And the next mode is the continuous motion triggered mode, wherein it wakes up and sends data on a movement, and it will again go back to sleep when there is no movement detected. Geofence triggered mode, this is a new mode we have added, wherein the everything except the GPS is off, and it checks for GPS location periodically, and if it has entered a certain area or exited a certain area, then it can be made to start sending the data. And this application is useful for security driven applications, wherein the device only needs to start or stop sending data whenever it enters or exits a certain area. This is useful for saving the data also, because everything is billed as per the bytes consumed these days. And we also made these small GPS trackers. These are the VALTRACK-V2MF series. These use a different GPS module, the Telit GPS modules. And as you can see here, the height of the module is quite less compared to the normal tracking devices like the V2, the VTB. This is made for hidden installation applications. So there is a significant difference in the height of the module. This module is a different variant of this module. It's having a higher or a taller antenna and has a little more sensitivity compared to this. So we can select either this or this. So normally for hidden installations, this one is recommended. This is a GNSS GPS module. I'll be making one more video on the V2MF soon. And I will tell the hardware details, whatever is available on this module. That's all for now. If you have any queries on the V2C, you can drop me a mail to ravi@valtracktron.com. And if you have any technical queries that needs to be answered, you can post it on my forum, embeddedadvice.com. And you can also check out my blog, www.raviyp.com. If you want to buy any of our products, it's available on valtracktron.com/store URL. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.